I have been waiting to record this episode for a while, and I am so stoked. See, in the world of marketing, let me say this. The world of marketing, okay? In the world, we have laws. We have things that govern the world. And I don't agree with all of them, but most of them serve a purpose. There are certain laws that keep us safe, that make everything easy, that literally ensure our safety that we all love, right? But yet, in the world of marketing, it's like the wild, wild west. And nobody gives a shit about following any of these things. And so I put together, after 10 years, the 7 marketing laws that I use no matter what. And I apply these to every business, everything I do, every single consulting, every podcast, everything that we do, I apply these laws. And these 7 laws, I call them the 7 laws of the sea. They are the most pivotal principles for me that have basically guaranteed I succeed at everything I do when it comes to digital marketing. So today, I'm really, really excited because I'm going to share the first law, the number one law of marketing. Okay. So my marketing law number one, I want you to write this down, remember this, keep this in your mind, burn it in. I'm going to say this like 20 times right now. I want you to remember, I want you to remember, I want you to remember, right? So let's open that loop. I want you to remember this law, burn it in, remember it, use it, apply it to every thought, every business, everything that you do inside of your life and business, including personal relationships. Okay. Marketing law number one. Everyone feels valued whether they give you a credit card or not. Marketing law number one. Everybody feels valued whether they give you a credit card or not. This is the most important law of marketing. I have 7. Remember, this is the most important one. We do not run businesses to get credit cards. We run businesses to deliver on the afterstates or promises we've made for our customers. So in your lighthouse or your beacon of belief that you've done with me, your what doesn't say, I help people ethically scale only when they give me a credit card, or I help empower women to live only when they buy my protein bar. No, it's about helping people. It's about helping people, okay? And I'm going to share a story, a quick story about Apple in a second. But before I do, when I just said beacon of belief and lighthouse, if you don't know what I'm talking about or if you haven't defined it yet, go to our website at mindofgeorge.com and sign up for our 7-day lighthouse blueprint mini course. It's all in there. It's included. It's free. This helps you solidify the foundational principles of your business and earn the right to scale and reach more people. It's a free course, and I guarantee you it's better than 99% of marketing course out there that you pay for and that costs thousands of dollars. And so, when we think about this marketing law, everyone feels valued whether they give you a credit card or not. We have to help people, even if somebody never pays you. So let's think about Apple for a minute. Like, let's think about the Apple store. If you've ever been in an Apple store, you walk in and it's like pandemonium. Everybody's playing with phones, they're touching stuff, they're using stuff. Most of those people don't buy products. They come to play, they come to get a touch point, they come to have an experience, they come to collect evidence, they come to see if they want it, they come to show off, they come to do a lot of things with it without buying, right? Now, can you imagine how successful Apple would be is if at the door they said you can't come in, you can't touch it, you can't play with it, or you can't use it until you buy it, or you know, you have to give me your credit card for blah, or you have to give me your credit card for blah. It wouldn't work. Apple owns 98% of the revenue of that market while only owning 2% of the market. Pay attention to that one, okay? So you have to remember that everybody, and I cover this in the conscious, subconscious customer journey, everybody is on a journey and they're at different paths of their journey. So in your business, if every time somebody comes to you, they feel like they have to pay, they don't have the space to be in their journey. There's not an actual chance for them to collect evidence to move forward in a relationship with you. And so when you give value agnostic of a credit card and help somebody achieve their goals, they become a marketing machine for you as they go tell the world about you and what you've helped them accomplish. Plus, let me ask you this question. If I was to put 2 people into a room, two people, right? I met 2 people and they came into the room and they all told me they had a problem. They told me that they each wanted to lose 10 pounds, right? And I was like, okay, cool. And I said, one of you, I need you to meet me back here in 7 days, okay? And then when you get back here, we'll talk about it. The other one of you, stay with me right now. Hey, listen, I'm going to want to help you, but I need you to do these things first. So for the next 7 days, I want you to drink this much water, walk a mile a day, and get into the practice of it, and then come back in 7 days. And so then when they're both back in 7 days, and I have them saying like, all right, guys, I'm ready to help you. It's going to be a year-long commitment. It's going to require this and this and this. Here's the order form. You know, let's get going. Which one do you think is going to commit? The one who has no idea, hasn't felt it, hasn't tasted it, and all the evidence is stacked against me, or the one that tasted it, got an experience of it, had momentum, had progress, and then wants to continue? People think that you have to hide things, that you have to hide information, that you have to like keep it at the cuff. No, that's bullshit. You don't. You don't. People don't buy the best product. They don't buy the best answer. They buy the best relationship. Everything that you have to offer, most of us included, can be found online for free. It can be found online for free. But what can't be is the messenger, and you're the messenger. And so what you're doing by giving value agnostic of a credit card is you're getting people indoctrinated into your world, into your beliefs, and into loving you before they ever pay. You are creating loyalty without realizing it, and you are informing their buying decisions for a very long time without them ever having to pay you, which means they pay you more and a lot more frequently, because that's how that works. It's just how we work as humans. It's just like at restaurants. Why do they give you a free dessert? Or why do they give you a free appetizer? Because it gets you into the restaurant. It gives you a reason to come in, and then you buy more, right? Why do bartenders give you your first drink for free? Because now when you drink it, you'll use that same money to buy a second one. And they know if once you've had that second drink, you're probably going to drink three or four more. And that's where they're going to make their revenue. Why do the best sommeliers at restaurants, when you're like, oh, I don't know about that bottle, and they're like, you know what? We'll pour you a taste. First glass is on me. Well, when it's a $400 bottle of wine, giving me a $65 glass for a taste, knowing that I was interested in it, probably going to really tilt the needle in my favor, and it works every time. These lessons are around us all the time. Digital marketing is no different. So the number one law of marketing is everyone must feel valued whether they give you a credit card or not. That means that they feel seen, they feel heard, and they feel respected. They feel helped, and they have a bright light to follow from your lighthouse, and they know exactly how they can take a next step in the relationship with your brand when they choose to. So look at the content you're sharing for your brand or the emails that you send. Is it giving people meaningful and relevant value to their wants and needs? And is it giving them the value right there where they're reading it, right? And let me explain this to you. Giving them the value doesn't mean like, hey, I have a secret. Click here to find the secret. Hey, now that you're on this page, give me your email to find the secret. Hey, now that I got your email, before I give you the secret, let me try to get you this. No, go F yourself. No, give them the value. All you're doing is making your business work, because you're filling your business with 1,000 people when only 10 of them wanted to be there. You have to pay for them all those burnt bridges and negative reputations that you're creating, instead of just giving the value on the front and allowing the 10 people that want to come in and convert, and the other ones to then come back to the next piece of content and next piece of content until they're ready. Part of the problem with this is that it convinces people to buy. And when it convinces people, it means they weren't really ready. You need to be enrolling people to buy. And your content and the value that you produce allows people to get committed to you, to experience you as a brand, to make their decisions, and to go full tilt with you. And it's the only way that you can succeed. Guaranteed. You'll have small areas of success and small pockets, but it's not sustainable and it never lasts. So you need to think about this when you're doing all of it, right? So like I said, look at the content that for sharing for your brand or the emails you sent. Is it giving them meaningful and relevant value to their wants and needs? And is it giving them that value right there where they're reading it? Meaning they don't have to click to the link to your website to get the value. They get the value in the post or in the email or in the video. They don't have to buy the product to get the value. They have tangible takeaways that help them succeed even if they don't buy your product, right? I explained this in our Lighthouse mini course, our Lighthouse method course, where really like lead magnets are the easiest things in the world to create, right? Like let's say you have a 10-step process. Your lead magnet's the first three steps. Let's say you have a 10-step process that your other lead magnet is the overview of the whole process and how to use it with one tangible takeaway. Like everything you do, everything you give value on is just helping these people become a better customer or moving them closer to becoming your customer. And all of this bullshit of like, oh, you know, comment with the word blah if you want me to send you blah. Like, go fuck yourself. Seriously. No. It's manipulative. It's not there. It doesn't work. it doesn't work and it doesn't help somebody move one step close to your brand. They're like, oh, this feels icky, or why do I have to do this, or this is so hard. And it's creating an anti-marketing machine. So stop, just stop doing it. Okay. So buying is an option that they can choose to take away the guesswork, to get the structure and accountability they need to keep momentum without second guessing what they should be working on and how to best execute. The same info that you put in a blog post is normally the same info that goes in a lead magnet, which is normally the same info that's in a paid product. The only difference is when it's in content, it's just an idea. When it's in a lead magnet, it's an idea with structure and accountability. When it's a product, it's an idea with structure, accountability, and access, and a few other things mixed in. But the content's always the same, right? If you're teaching me how to properly walk, there's really only one way to properly walk, and there's multiple iterations to get there. But when I make a decision to pay you as my walking coach, really extreme example, to pay you as my walking coach, I'm paying for you because I trust you. I believe in you. I believe in the way in which you deliver the information is the best way to support me. And so that's one of the things that you want to be thinking about when you go through this, okay? So marketing law number one, repeat this with me. Everyone feels valued whether they give you their credit card or not. Everyone feels valued whether they give you their credit card or not. And if you want a good book recommendation, read the book Contagious by Jonah Berger. But 86% of marketing is word of mouth. And so imagine this. If I put 100 people in a room, okay, on day one, and 100 people, and I share them information, presentation, I'm like, all right, cool. Now, if you want the rest of it, like if you want the secret, give me your credit card, it's $100. Maybe I'll get 15 people to buy, right? That means the other 85 had a negative experience with me. So when someone's like, hey, did you go to George's seminar? They're like, yeah, but like I listened to him for an hour. He got me on roll, but then he told me he had to pay me for the secret. Like I had to pay him and I just wanted to see a taste of it. Like, no, I wouldn't recommend going, right? That happens, right? Then thinking about again, day two, I put 100 people in the room, okay? And I speak to them for the hour. And then I'm like, and listen, before we even get started, I want to give you this right now. I want to go through this. Instead of just this presentation, we're going to do this exercise together. I want you to do this. I want you to do this. I want you to do this. And if you like that, and if it feels good and you want more of it, then come into our course. And if you don't, keep putting this into practice in the next 30 days or 60 days in your life, and I'll be here to support you. Which one do you think is going to work better? Which one do you think leverages 86% of word of mouth marketing? Which one do you think fills a customer's brain with the ammunition to give you as a positive recommendation when the average person gives 8 to 10 brand recommendations or non-recommendations in a 60-second conversation? You need to be constantly thinking about the ammunition you're giving people. And if you're not giving them any, then you're not going to like the results. You have to tell them what to say by giving them the value and making sure that all they can say is positive things and all they can talk about is their momentum and progress. Or else you're going to have people talking about how frustrated they are or how difficult your content is or how they don't understand your product. And so there's multiple levels to the effectiveness of this law, but I want you to listen to it. I want you to own it and I want you to embody it. It will transform your business, I guarantee you, okay? So I have a challenge for you this week. I want you to be hyper aware of the value that you're giving and ensuring people can get tangible takeaways even if they don't click the link or watch the video or buy your product. Meet them where they are and meet them with value so that their next step is to come deeper into your world and make a commitment, okay? So here's my call to action. What do you plan to do to continue making meaningful impact in your current and potential customer's life? So I want you to go make a post in our Facebook group. Go to the Relationship Speed Algorithms Facebook group, and I want you to do a post in the group answering this question. Okay. I want the group to cheer you on and offer feedback, and I want to read them. And trust me, I am paying attention to how many of you do this. And yes, I know there's some of you that are listening to this. They're like, yeah, I'm not doing that. That's fine. Don't fucking do it. I don't care. If you want to do it, I'll support you. My team will support you. And if you don't do it, I still love you. That's fine. Whenever you're ready, come drop it. But I challenge you to drop it. So here's the question. I want you to go answer this question in the Facebook group. What do you plan to do to continue making meaningful impact in your current and potential customers' life? Go answer that question in the form of a statement like this. The way I plan to continue making meaningful impact in my current potential customers' lives is this, 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 this. Do a video, do a post, and post it in our Facebook group. And I'm going to continue to drip out the 7 marketing laws to you on the podcast over the next couple of weeks. And I challenge you to really consider these marketing laws and look at where you can use them in your business and utilize our relationship. Share your thoughts with me in the group. I really do read your posts and comments, me and the team. It's Kais, me and Tyler. And if you want access to everything right now, I do cover the 7 marketing laws in one of our lessons from our new Lighthouse Method course. And that is a 9-step program for going from unknown to well-known from the people who actually become your customers. Covers creating compelling offers that move your ideal buyers into action, mapping the customer journey, building the lead magnets and funnels, content strategy, social media mastery, and more. It's among the most valuable things I've made in my entire career. And you can find the Lighthouse Method course. It's linked on mindofgeorge.com to get all the details you need. So just go to mindofgeorge.com. It's right there. And so my ask for you this week, number one, my challenge, post in the Facebook group the answer to that question. What do you plan to do to continue making meaningful impact in your current and potential customer's life? And then my second call to action for you, if you have not joined us in the Lighthouse Method course, I'm going to kick you in the shins. It's the biggest gift I've ever given the world. Plus, we do live coaching calls where you all get to come on Zoom with me. We put you hot seats in your business and we go through it all. And I want to do that with you too. So go check it out. Go to mindofgeorge.com, click on the Lighthouse Method course, and we will see you on the inside. So without further ado, remember that relationships always beat algorithms, and I will see you in the next episode.